everybody, it's Monday. I'm gonna vlog. So, I don't know if I told you guys or not, but last Wednesday, I sprained my ankle. Yes, I currently have a sprained ankle right now. What had happened was, it's been a chaotic week because I don't have a cart. So, like, Monday, my boyfriend was here and he had his truck here, and I was able to use that to go to work. And then Tuesday, I found out all about the colorful world of Uber. I have never taken Uber before, and I am forced to take Uber now every day to go to work because I don't have a car. Well, I have a car, but it has two bullet holes in the windshield, and the dashboard is completely obliterated. So, I have to take Uber now. So Tuesday, I took an Uber. It was fine. My Uber experience going to work was okay, and then coming home from work was fine as well. So Wednesday, I had to take another Uber. But Monday, I saw this crazy patient that I have, super psycho. So psycho in fact that when Dragon first came to work in the pharmacy with us, she threatened to slash her tires, and Dragon called the police and had her banned from the pharmacy for a while. But she eventually won her way back into our hearts, and she's so nice. She gave us some guppies as pets in the pharmacy, so I have like a fish bowl with actual fish at work. So keeps me sane. She brought a roommate for the fish. The roommate died 6 months later, so I bought two more guppies, so now we have three guppies there, so they're all good. I think one of them is pregnant though, but I'm not sure. It's just, this fish is ginormous. He's like Jaws of the fucking fish bowl. But anyway, this crazy lady spoke to me on Monday and was talking about she found Jesus or something, and suddenly she's like working with charities to give back to kids and whatever. And she's like, oh, do you have a kid? Like, does your kid not play with toys or have clothes she doesn't use and stuff like that? You know, give them to me and we're gonna give them to these poor kids, and you know, stuff like that. So I was like, yeah, I promise. She's like, when can I have the stuff? I'm like, Wednesday. I promise I'm gonna bring you a bag of toys Wednesday. Here we are Wednesday, and my second day catching the Uber, and freaking, I get this lady, and she got to my house like super quick. So I completely forgot that I promised this lady I was going to bring her a bag of toys. So I run to my daughter's room, I just grab a bunch of crap and throw it in the bag, and then I'm rushing outside. So as I'm going down the stairs, I'm in a rush, and then I have all these stray animals that I feed. It was just like a disaster. I didn't watch my step, and so I went from the top of the stairs and I put my ankle, my other foot, all the way to the bottom of the stairs, and all my weight went on my ankle and twisted it out, and I was out. I was down, and I fell in front of school children and my Uber driver. My Uber driver was like, didn't get out the car to help me or anything, so I kind of had to like pick myself off the floor and kind of assess the damage. And then she got out the car and came, and she's like, what do you want to do? And I was just like, just give me a second. Let me try to walk this shit off. And I was moving my ankle around, and I could move it still, and I could kind of put my weight on it. So I was just like, okay, I can walk around. I don't think it's sprained. I've sprained my ankle before when I was younger, and I couldn't put any weight on it whatsoever. So maybe it's not sprained. Maybe I just bust my ass. So whatever, I got in the car, went with this idiot, and then she picked up somebody else, and then that person got us completely late. Like, this lady was lost, and in the meantime, I'm in the backseat just like, oh god, my ankle feels like shit. I get to work really late, and my ankle is like slowly just swelling up in the pharmacy. I get to work with my boss, we're by ourselves, and I told him what happened, and then he's just like concerned. I lift my pants up, and my ankle is just like canned ham. It's just spam at this point. It's just this big brick of pink. And he's like, oh, that's not good. So I worked on this leg for like an hour, maybe 2 hours. And he's like, listen, you have to go. You clearly have sprained your ankle. You have to go home. I'm going to call everybody else so they come and cover your shift. I was like, okay. So whatever, I go home, and my ankle's a disaster. I called my boyfriend, and he came and picked me up from work, took me home. My ankle's trashed. The next day I was supposed to go to work. I did not expect my ankle to be this bad, and so they had to find someone else. I was texting people, I was asking people to come cover my shift, and there was nobody. And then finally I spoke to my pharmacist. I said, listen, I'm gonna just wrap the shit up. I'll walk on a cane if I have to, and just, like, we can do this. And the person was like, no, 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 I'm gonna find someone. And they did. They found someone to cover my shift on Thursday. So I got Thursday off and Friday off and then Saturday off. But I did have to work yesterday, Sunday. So, limped my butt in work. My pharmacist, the Russian, made me sit on the stool all day. And I couldn't really do much. The store was a mess. Oh, God. I just wanted to clean the place up and get it nice. I found out over the weekend that Minnie is leaving the pharmacy. She's actually going to go work with Dragon. Apparently she has some kind of strife and nobody knew about it, and now she's decided to just quit the pharmacy and go work somewhere else. So I'm going to work just like really nervous. Like, I need everything to be perfect because it's the beginning of the month. Every first of the month I have to process all the expired medications we have in the store, and I have to do a lot of inventory shit, and like, I can't be sidetracked by all this other excess job stuff that could have been done. So I'm working Sunday and I can't really do much because the Russian has me sitting on a pedestal literally and just is telling me, like, please don't injure yourself, like, you're our last hope. So I get to work today and, oh boy, we open today at 9. They've changed the pharmacy hours, so we open an hour later. So, like, all the 8 o'clock crowd was there when I got to work. My pharmacist was super, super serious. He was like, he's one of those people that when they get stressed out, they get quiet. They kind of get, it's like something I would do, so I can totally relate to that. The Russian pharmacist showed up and was just, she came with her daughter to like buy aspirin or something. Something small like that, like a small purchase. Like, here, I've come this morning to buy bubblegum. So she clearly just wanted to see for herself how things were. And she told the other pharmacist, she's like, listen, you know, she worked yesterday, her leg is, you know, just have her type, have her answer the phone and stuff like that. You could do everything else until, you know, everybody else comes along. So Minnie was calling out today, so I wasn't expecting her to come at all. And they were trying to find coverage for her, nobody could come. So today was just super busy. We were like so behind. It was like 5 o'clock when I left and they were still just doing shit. So Minnie rolled up in there almost at 1 o'clock and the atmosphere was tense. So, like, I don't know, like, she's great. She gave me a ride home. Oh my god, I forgot. Tuesday she gave me a ride home. That's how I got home from work, actually. Tuesday I stayed like half an hour extra after my shift. And I got off with her and she took me home, as a matter of fact. Yeah, that's right. So, I mean, and on the ride home, we were having a great time. This is why when, like, Friday, Saturday came around and my Russian pharmacist was texting me that, oh, this girl's quitting, I found it so surprising. It's a lot of character for her. So, she, you know, she rolled up there today and it was just, like, really tense. We were just so stressed out and serious. And, you know, she kept making, like, little remarks and stuff. She said something to me like, oh, what happened? You didn't get much done. And I, my God, like, I had to suppress a lot inside of me because she's only 21 and she's young and dumb and 21. And, wanted to go off on her. But I did a little going off on her kind of my own way. I kind of was just like, yeah, do you not see my fucking foot? You know, like, you can't get much done with this sprained ankle, you know? So my pharmacist was also very, very serious with her. And then he kind of put her on blast suddenly. He was just like, okay, let's talk about it. Why are you quitting? And then he, useless by then, came to work. And we all kind of just got around her and were asking her, like, what's up? And she was just saying that, I asked her flat out, I'm like, is it personal or is it just like, do you have a problem with us? Do you have a problem in your life? Like, what is the deal? And she's like, oh, it's both. She's like, I don't feel appreciated at work. I feel like it's just, it's too much. And who knows what else is within her personal self, but I had to roll my eyes. I'm just like, this is work. We all hate our jobs. You're never gonna be appreciated at work. This is not gonna happen, Captain. It's just not gonna happen. No matter what job you go to, you could be a scientist at NASA. You're gonna hate your fucking life and your job and your boss and your coworkers, because that's how work works. So my pharmacist was just like telling her pretty much a similar thing. Like, listen, it doesn't matter where you go. You're always gonna take you with you. And if this is how you handle stress, to just get up and take off, then you're gonna go through a lot of jobs. And you know, she kind of started to cry, and she felt like everyone was attacking her. And we kind of like, we're not attacking you, but we kind of are, because fuck, now we're gonna have to go through a lot of fucking hassle because of your little ass. But if she wants to go, then what can you do? You know, bye. To myself, I was kind of like, I had my own problems. Like, today I had to call my car insurance because it's been a week and I don't have anyone. I don't have an insurance adjuster that has come out and looked at my car. I don't have a police report. I took an Uber to the freaking police station on Friday to get a police report because my apartment building won't change my window until they have a police report. And then I am thinking that I can't go to housing and speak with someone because I'm super traumatized sleeping in here. You know, like, sometimes, like, this weekend I sat by the window, by like where my computer is, and suddenly I was just like, I don't want to sit here. Like, I felt really just like scared, you know, like I don't want to be here, you know. I don't want to be leaning against my headboard. I don't want to be in my room, you know. I'm just you know, like I keep thinking something's gonna happen, and you know, it's not good. So I want to talk to someone from housing about that. I just want to see if maybe I can move, or I don't know what. But I need a police report. I don't have one. I went to the freaking police department. They told me it wasn't ready. It's in the detective's queue or whatever the fuck that means. And come back next Friday. So, complete waste of time. I called my insurance today. Apparently, my bullshit cheap-ass insurance that I can only afford this fucking coverage doesn't cover anything to my car. So I have to pay for a windshield with bullet holes and my busted up dashboard all by myself. All these Uber fucking rides, I'm not gonna get reimbursed for. I have to basically eat up this whole cost, this whole thing that has happened to me. And I was just like super serious and upset at work. I was not having it from anyone, you know. So you know, I like the girl, I do, but she's leaving. So, and to myself, I'm just like, bye, you know, you're gone already. I'm thinking about next month. I'm thinking about next week. I'm thinking about how is this going to affect me and stress me out. So, toodles, good luck in life. But I have serious problems right now. So, yeah. So, that's today. Sucks. I bought a bottle of tequila the minute I got out of work. And so, I'm going to continue to drink that. Still a little bit early. And another thing, my kid's father, apparently they can't afford where he lives, so now he's gonna be having this little old man as a roommate. So now he's gonna drop my daughter off every night to me and pick her up every morning to go to school, because he's gonna have an actual man living with him and my daughter can't ever spend the night there because there's no bed. So now I have to have like legit dinner every night here. And it sucks because I don't have a car to do groceries. I've been going to the corner store and like fucking getting price gouged up the ass for like basic ham and cheese and bread and shit. So, oh my god. It sucks. Oh lord. I'm super stressed out. I need more tequila. So that's it. I'm gonna go. Hope you guys are okay. And I'm gonna upload this. Should be ready tomorrow or the following day. Who the fuck knows. And that's it. Good night. Goodbye.